Okay, hello, my name is Kenneth, and I'm going to show you how to make 24 liters of pasta sauce. I've been working on this pasta sauce now for almost 40 years, and it has improved over the time. I think it's very important that the consistency is as good as the taste. And that, unfortunately, takes 3 days. But you don't have to work that whole time. So I'm going to give you an idea of what I've just been to the store, the things that I think that must go into the sauce. Some of these things have to be done separately, but not most of them. So don't be frightened by the amount of food. Remember, we're making 24 liters. You see these two pots? That's what we're doing. There's going to be some vegetables in this. And here you see the various vegetables. The onions, both red and white, are very important and need to be done separately and really, you know, burnt. The mushrooms also have to be done separately. But many of the other things can be just cut and put in once we have the sauce working. Over here, you see, these are various pasta sauces that I use as the basis. These are some really good ones that are available in Norway. Some of these are, you know, here. For example, these two, which are just a basic basil sauce, which is excellent, and a cheesy sauce. I've got about 4 or 5 of these cheesy sauces, which I think is very important. And I'm going to add some, you know, pesto and green and red pesto. I add a lot of this stuff, you know, chopped up tomatoes, tomato paste. These things are very essential. I even get some packed oregano because there's so much oregano has got to go into it, so you need oregano. Seasons, you need a lot of garlic powder, which is important. I'll use probably half of this in each one of those things, this excellent type of grind spicy. I tend to add a little bit of these dried onions in addition to everything else. They give an interesting taste. And I add a few peanuts and a few cashews to the mix. I also add some, in English, it's called red cabbage.
Mm-hmm.
This is rucola, and it's very sweet, and that's great. Don't underestimate, I'll probably use one of these in each of the pots. Very important. In fact, this is how the whole thing began, you know, 40 years ago. It was basically just pasta and a little butter and ketchup, which is pretty bloody good and hard to improve upon. I'll probably put some, you know, cheeses on, some fatty cheeses. My preference is usually a Philadelphia. And then I have a couple tins things that I'm going to add. Like I do, as you can see, I have a lot of mushrooms, but I'll add some tinned mushrooms. And also, you know, about a decade ago, I started adding a little bit of corn to it, and about 90% of the people like that. So I don't put too much in, but it is very attractive in a pasta. And then here's some, you know, sun-dried tomatoes. I have a couple of these. Mango chutney is essential to give, you know, to give it adequate sweetness. And so what I'm going to do is now I'm going to spend a few hours cutting and chopping while I, you know, do some onions, get them nice and burnt in oil and ready to go in separately. And then that will be the first thing that goes in, are the onions, and then everything else will be entered separately. And I don't know how much of that you really need to see. But the important thing is to try to complete this task during this day and get both of these things filled and simmering just for the rest of this day. And then at night, I'm going to take it out and make it cold. Luckily, we're in Norway, so just take it outside, gets cold. And then I'll take it in and I'll let it again simmer for another maybe 16 hours the next day. Very important. Then I'll take it out again, cool it down that night, and bring it up to simmering the next day. And that will be the day of harvest, when we should get about, you know, almost 20 great pasta meals out of this. And that's what I really look forward to, that moment. Okay, so I'm just gonna get started cutting and chopping and getting to work. Garlic powder. And of course, tamari. This is important. This is some of the hardest part, is the onions. Tamari, look, and now I gotta get sugar.
I can't believe you went swimming, man.
It's so lovely. I started with my just my feet, and then I just kind of slid into it. So gorgeous.
I used to have something very long. It was stirring. So that's going to go kind of in. I can just go into the sauce. The other ones I'm gonna roast, is that it?
My vegetables card off and said, my vegetables, I love you, most of all. My favorite vegetable.
Roasted garlic and peanuts. Oregano. I gotta get this thing up to simmering before I go to sleep. I'll do side for side, like.
All right.
Good tool, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's encouraging. It's better than I feared. The next test is to put these in. One of each. I mean, not one of each. One in each. I don't want the oil.
Okay, gotcha.
I want just the dried tomatoes.
So two and two.
Yeah, two and two. Well done. And now I think the rest goes in tomorrow. Let's get this thing warmed up. Excuse me.
It's very heavy.
Here we go. Okay, I'll turn this on to 1.5.
We stir it first? No?
Not everything is in there. There's still quite a bit to go in. But if we fill them up to the top, it'll be very difficult to stir. So we're going to let these cook through the evening and hopefully get them hot enough that we can cool it down tonight and then tomorrow do some serious simmering. I think they sort of disappear. This is the red cabbage, which is very sweet. It should be sort of sweet. I don't always do the corn in. I know some people who are surprised to see the corn, but I really like it. And I think it adds a texture and it adds another color.
Mm-hmm.
You know, which is great. It's like the carrots, you know, things. It's like the Brussels sprouts. The colors are very important to the whole experience.
Right.
Thank you.
Wow.
Good. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Good. It's amazing, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to discuss the spreusteckt
lök.
Yeah, I think I'll put a little more sugar in here too. This is very important.
Okay.
We're going to do a lot of this. I need a lot of this. Sugar. Not too much. And you have to taste it at the end to decide how much you're going to have to add. I just put a little on during the process.
Yeah.
How many people are going to eat this?
Four people can eat this 25 times.
Yeah. I don't think, usually it's more like 22 or 21. The issue is that these need to be cooked too. Try to get them to the bottom or something.
We did it.
Come into it. Maybe she put it all back into the banana peel.
You have to put the Parmesan in while you're stirring continually. Hopefully you have an assistant who can do that for you.
Copy that.
Excuse me. Okay. And that will be the day of harvest, when we should get about, you know, almost 20 great pasta meals out of this. And that's what I really look forward to, that moment. So there's 20.
Nice.
I get around.
bar, cause it's never been deep, and we've never messed yet with the girls we meet.